So welcome you all. In the previous topic we were discussing about the vapor compression refrigeration cycle. So next type is about the vapor absorption refrigeration cycle. So now we are going to discuss along with the block diagram you can able to see. So again the major parts of this refrigeration cycle is evaporator, absorber, heat exchanger, we are going to use the pump, generator, condenser and expansion valve. So now we're going to discuss about the working principle or working of this refrigeration system. So you can able to see already in the evaporator, here we're going to use as the refrigerants. So refrigerants nothing but we're going to use as an ammonia. Ammonia we're going to use as an refrigerant for this vapor absorption refrigeration cycle. So you can able to see the already in the evaporator tube some the refrigerant will be present. That is the refrigerant is nothing but an ammonia. Ammonia will be in the form of refrigerant, it will be used in the evaporator. What happens when in the evaporator you can able to see normally it will be in the low pressure and with the low temperature it will be ammonia will be in the form of liquid in the evaporator. Once the evaporator starts absorbing the heat content, where it starts the absorbing the heat content. So in the evaporator is nothing but the whenever we are keeping any food contents or any items inside the refrigeration, what happens here is about the some heat content will be there. So that heat content will be absorbed in the form of evaporator, that is in the cabinet. Cabinet is nothing but an which is a system which is present inside the refrigerator. Whenever you are keeping the any stuff inside the refrigerator, automatically it will be in the surrounding temperature. So whenever it is in the surrounding means automatically the heat content will be present in the that particular item. So now what happens, this evaporator starts absorbing that heat content which is present on that particular item. Now what happens, initially the refrigerator evaporator will be low pressure with the low temperature, the ammonia used as a refrigerant, it will be in the form of liquid. When once what happens when it starts absorbing the heat content here is when it changes its phase, the refrigerant changes from liquid to vapor. How it changes? Because whenever you are going to heat the liquid, of any liquid, automatically when the heat is more, automatically the liquid starts changing into the form of vapor, that is vapor. So here also because of the heat absorbed from the items what it is there in the refrigerator, automatically it changes from liquid state to the vapor state. Now from the evaporator it starts moving to the absorber. Now the condition of the liquid will be, it will be in the low pressure with the low temperature only, but it has been changed from liquid to vapor phase change, means from liquid phase to the vapor phase because of the heat absorbed here. When it reaches to the absorber, what happens in the function of this absorber is because the ammonia we use as in a refrigerant here. So ammonia is very good, ammonia plus water is having a good combination here. Here what happens, whenever it mixes the ammonia, it mixes with the water, automatically the it starts dissolving, the ammonia starts getting dissolving in these conditions. So when what happens to the dissolving these conditions, again the weak solution will be start dissolving there. Only the strong solution of the or a strong ammonia solution only will be present in this. What happens when this, whenever it mixes with the water, the ammonia when it mixes with the water, the weak solution of ammonia will be starts dissolving there. Only the strong solution of ammonia will be there. Once it starts dissolving, what happened? Now again from it, when it is moving to the absorber, now with the low pressure and with the low temperature, now the solution is in the form of liquid. Only the strong solution of ammonia will be moving. So how we can able to move? As we told in the second law of thermodynamics, heat cannot flow from lower temperature to the higher temperature without the external agency. So now this is the without the external agency heat cannot flow. Now with the external agency we are going to use the pump. So by using the pump we are going to pump this strong ammonia solution with the weak ammonia solution through the pump. It passes through the heat exchanger. What happens when it passes through the again to the heat exchanger, the ammonia will be get heated here, means the strong solution of ammonia will be get heated here. When it get heated here, that ammonia, strong ammonia will be going with the high pressure and high temperature. Why? Because the heating we have been done with the ammonia. Once the heating is done, automatically the temperature is increased. Once the temperature is increased, automatically the pressure is increased for that ammonia solution. Now what happens here when it reaches to the generator? Again when it reaches to the generator,
the external source of heating is being done. What is the purpose of external sourcing of heating is, so the evaporators, which is the vapor is content is present, that vapor starts evaporating here. What happens is, why we are using this heating coil is to get heating here. What happens when heating this ammonia strong solution is, again, which is the vapor content is there, which starts evaporating now. So remaining ammonia content which is there, that passes through the condenser. Again, what is the process of condenser, or what is the function of this condenser is to, it condenses, or it reduces the heat, means it absorbs the heat. How it going to absorb? So it absorbs the heat and it sends to the surroundings. Surroundings means is nothing but the out of the system, where you can able to see the backside of the refrigeration system. Always it will be heat, means the heat content will be there. Why the heat content means, which is the, what is the heat content which is there on the all the items, that will be sending through this from the condenser only. Now what happens, this ammonia solution, what is there with the strong ammonia solution which is coming to the condenser, it will be in the form of vapor. Now what happens after coming to the condenser, now the pressure also with the high pressure and high temperature. Now what happens here, when it reaches to the condenser, the heat will be absorbed here, means the heat starts rejecting from condenser to the surroundings. Now when it starts rejecting this from surrounding to the heat, again the liquid, the ammonium liquid will be formed from vapor to the liquid. Why? Because the temperature has been reduced, but the pressure will be same. The pressure will be not reduced, but the temperature of the ammonia will be reduced, means the temperature of the refrigerant will be reduced with the help of this condenser. From this condenser, again it starts moving to the expansion now. Now when after from moving from condenser, the refrigerant, ammonia refrigerant will be with the high pressure with low temperature liquid. Here the phase has been changed. You can able to see from here, it has been changing the phase from liquid to vapor. Now again from the, after reaching to the condenser, now it has been changed the phase of that ammonia refrigerant is from liquid, from vapor to liquid. How it has been changed the phases from vapor to the liquid is, here the condenser has been extracts the heat content which is present on that liquid. What happens when if you reduce the heat, automatically the vapor will become the liquid content. Now that liquid is moving with the high pressure with low temperature liquid. Now what happens when it reaches to the expansion wall, automatically why the pressure is, because we have compressed this vapor. So when compressing, automatically the pressure is increased. Now we have reduced the temperature in the condenser. Now the pressure, high pressure with low temperature liquid, when it reaches to the expansion wall, automatically it reduces the pressure, because the expansion wall will open. So in that, when it reduces the pressure here, now again the ammonia refrigerant, what we use as ammonia, is moving from again low pressure to low temperature liquid. Again it moves to the evaporator and this process starts circulating, means again the process will keep on continuing. So you can able to see the vapor absorption system consists an absorber, where it is used for a circular pump and heat come separator, condenser. Here we are using as in a dry ammonia vapor. So that is dissolved in the weak ammonia solution for ammonia water. It will be in the absorber which will produce the strong ammonia solution, where it is will be in the form of cold water. After that, circulating pump draws the ammonia solution from the absorber and to the pump. It is to the heat exchanger, where it is warmed by the weak ammonia solution which is flowing back from the heat separator. You can able to see that from the heat exchanger, again the warm high pressure strong ammonia solution is passed to the heater cum separator provided with this heating coils. So this is the process of vapor absorption refrigeration system. So now we can able to observe the difference between the compression and absorption is, where we are going to use as a both the compressor, here we are going to use as in a generator. Instead of compressor there, we are going to use in a generator. So remaining condenser and evaporator and expansion valve is remain same, but here additionally we are going to heat the heaters there, and we are going to use the pump to pump that fluid that is refrigerant from absorber to the generator. We are going to pump. So by using that pump, and we are going to use the heaters in order to increase the temperature and to make the separate of strong ammonia solution and weak ammonia solutions, in order to reduce the temperature of that particular refrigerant. So this is the about type of refrigerant we are using here is ammonia. In that vapor compression refrigeration system, we are used as an ammonia as Ferron 10 and Ferron 12. So these are the types of refrigerants that has been used in order in the evaporators, in order to absorb the heat content.